In this video, we'll derive the sine rule. Now, I've drawn two triangles here. We'll take the triangle on the left first, and we can see in this triangle over here that we can have that h over c, opposite of the hypotenuse, is equal to the sine of the angle A. Which, of course, that implies that h will be equal to c sine a. Now on the other side we can see that h over a will be equal to h of a is equal to the sine of the angle c. That implies of course that h equals a sine c. Now because both h equals this one and h equals that one, this means, of course, that C will sine A equals A sine C. Now, with a little bit of algebraic manipulation, we can see that C over sine C, dividing both sides by sine C, is equal to A over sine A, dividing both sides by sine A. Right, so we're almost there. Looking on the other side, we've got a different height this time, and we're looking at this triangle at the top here. We can see that h over c equals the sine of b, which implies that h equals c sine b. Excuse me, that's my cat wanting to come in. Okay, be quiet, Teddy. Alright, then we're going to have h over b in this triangle here equals the sine of c. Means that h equals b sine c. And again we're going to say that c sine b equals b sine c. And dividing both sides again, we can see it's C on sine C equals B on sine B. Now, C on sine C equals B on sine B. Therefore, they all must be equal. So we have A on sine A equals B on sine B equals C on sine C. And I apologize for my cat making that noise. Alright, well that's the derivation of the sine rule. Thank you for watching.